What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back at it again with another video. So, we're going to check out Edge attacks Seth Rollins. I'm interested to see how this segment is going to play out. I did check out the Paul Heyman, Roman Reigns, Uso segment. I'll talk about that at the end of this video. But I want to talk about this one because I actually am interested in their feud, even though this is a secondary feud to what Roman and Brock got going on at Crown Jewel. This is still very worthy of attention, and I'm liking where this is going. Seth Rollins went to Edge's crib, so it's getting a little bit more personal. They both won one match against each other, so I'm looking forward to seeing where things go here. Appreciate all the love and support, man. You guys have been showing me so much love on the videos, and I want to thank you guys so much for that. So let's get right into this, man. I'll probably have to cut it up for YouTube purposes.
Hell, I've been waiting all my life for a moment like this.
Just so the video don't get blocked.
We don't even have to do this tonight, man. Hey, you name the time. You name the place. Hell, you can even name the stipulation. We can have a ladder match, a street fight, no holds barred. It don't matter, man. Come on. We can even have it. We can even have the match in your living room.
Oh.
Your wife and your daughters can cheer you on. Come on.
He's getting personal. He's getting personal. I like this.
I ended him with one stomp at Madison Square Garden.
That was a good match, too. Very enjoyable match. I like their feud, man. Can we just say these are wrestlers in different generations actually putting on some pretty good product, man. It's getting Seth over as a mega heel. I wouldn't say he's a mega heel, but he's a heel that people want to see lose. And it's definitely giving Edge some new life because he's going against someone, you know what I'm saying? He's never really went against in like this era of wrestling, like this generation of wrestlers. So I think it's pretty cool that we're getting a mixture of generations of wrestlers going at it, and it gels really well.
You're not just disappointing me.
Uh-oh, he's about to get
You're
personal.
You're disappointing all of your fans, man.
I think he's going to get a little bit more
You're
personal.
Disappointing all of your fans, and more importantly.
Yep, he's getting personal. I know he's going to go to the family route. He's going to go to the family
You're
route.
Disappointing your family.
Yep.
What? Is that here? Do we know? Is he speaking to a wall right now?
It's embarrassing, but it's true. I mean, I cannot imagine what it's like for your little girls to know that their daddy.
Oh, he's getting so personal.
He's no longer an inspiration.
All I need to see in the comment section is just, you think you know me. 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 Because you know it's coming, bro.
Truth.
He is. I
he
like
is
this.
Coward.
Wow, I like this.
It must break their little hearts.
I love
into
this.
Tiny pieces. He's such.
Uh oh. You think you know me? You think you know me? You think you know me? That's all that's playing in his head. Uh oh. Let's go. I'm waiting for it.
Edge did show up. Superstar.
Do y'all see how Edge is looking? He looks like a deranged killer. I love it, man. Let's go. Woo! Let's go. Woo! He beat his ass. Oh, shit. Oh, he getting his ass whooped now. He tripping on the announce court. Oh, bro, he trying to choke him with the announce court. This is great. Oh. Get your ass in this ring. I'm not done with you. Give me a chair. Let's go. Yes. Let's go. You think you know me, you think you know me, you think you know me. Let's get it. Let's get it. Go to that.
First the mic, now the steel, and Seth elbows. Seth elbows. You, me, Hell in a Cell.
Oh, 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 let's go. Oh, yes, yes. You hear the yes chants even still in WWE. Bryan Danielson, Daniel Bryan, whatever you want to call him, will still always be over. And the yes chants will always be over. Oh, yes. Yes. Look at his face of shock. Oh.
San Jose wants it as well.
Yes.
The look on Seth Rollins' face.
Yes.
Maybe I pushed a bit too far.
My God. Yes, I'm for it, bro. I'm for it. Y'all know how I don't really too much care for Hell in a Cell anymore, only because a lot of the matches don't even deserve to be in Hell in a Cell. This deserves to be in Hell in a Cell. This is what you call a personal feud. It has gotten personal. Edge doesn't want no regular stipulation match, no. He wants to end Seth Rollins. Sign me up. The last time we've seen a Hell in a Cell that made sense and the feud kind of fit the Hell in a Cell theme, it was a personal feud, was when Roman was going against Jey Uso. That's the last time it made sense for a Hell in a Cell match to be, you know, be the I guess you could say the external force, because it was a personal blood feud between family members. This is not between family members, but this feud has gotten very personal, and I love feuds like this. If they end in Hell in a Cell, it makes sense. Both wrestlers have won their respective matches against each other. This is the third match, probably the final match between these two. Hey man, I'm all for it, bro. I'm all for it. Seth Rollins sold it like, oh no, what have I done? Edge is going to look like a fucking monster, a maniac, and all he's going to be hearing is, you think you know me, you think you know me. Hey man, this was dope. I enjoyed this segment, and it seems like this segment ended off the show, rightfully so. Definitely something I'm looking forward to. Want to talk about real quickly the Paul Heyman, Roman Reigns, Usos segment. It was basically pretty much Paul Heyman pleading his case, kissing ass to Roman Reigns, obviously so, and basically making a statement saying, hey, you know, because Brock wasn't there, but like, hey, Brock, you ain't got no chance against Roman, and that's all Roman wanted. He wanted to see really where his allegiance lies, and he's over here basically saying, yo, I don't, you know what I'm saying, I want to believe you didn't make him a free agent, you know what I'm saying, to betray me. And he pretty much, Paul Heyman is pleading his case. So that's pretty much what that was. That whole storyline is, you know, was all about at the beginning. I believe that was at the beginning of the show. That was pretty much what they was talking about. So yeah, man, I'm looking forward to seeing, where does Paul Heyman's loyalty truly lie? Because he could be playing Roman. Who knows? I'm interested to see where that goes, man. But yeah, I'm excited. Hell in a Cell, sign me up, man. This definitely needs to happen, and it's going to bring some more excitement to the product. I'm not sure if this is going to take place when they're on Monday Night Raw, obviously. I'm not sure, because they're both going to be on Raw. So I'm not sure when this is going to take place. But yeah, I'm sign me up. Let's get this match going. Looking forward to it. But appreciate all the love and support on the channel, man. Comment down below. Let me know if you guys are excited for Edge, Seth, Hell in a Cell, and who would you guys have win? Me personally, I would probably have Edge win. I think I would give it to Edge. Seth Rollins could possibly take a loss here. I'm not sure. But either way, the decision would be fine with me. But I would give it to Edge in this particular situation. But appreciate all the love and support. Road to 60K. Appreciate y'all kicking in with me. See y'all on the next one. Peace.